Good morning, everybody. Friendly reminder, please make sure your cell phones are silenced for the duration of the Mass. Today's Mass is being offered for Gabriel Carter and all St. Vincent de Paul Ill benefactors, volunteers, brothers and sisters, and deceased benefactors and volunteers of St. Vincent de Paul. Next week, we will have a penitence service on March the 24th at 6 p.m. here in the main church. If your business could use a few more customers, consider advertising in the parish bulletin. A representative from our parish will be offering discounts this coming week. Please call the parish office for more information. Stations of the Cross, every Friday at 6 p.m. during Lent, schedules can be found on our website. Join the Knights of Columbus for their Lenten fish and shrimp fry during Lent at St. John's Hall every Friday beginning at 5 and going through 7 p.m. Our next Nicodemus night will be Saturday, April the 12th at 6:15 with prayer, reflections, and music. The Mom Ministry is hosting a Lenten family reunion renewal on Saturday, April the 2nd, 9 a.m., with confessions and adoration. More information can be found in the bulletin. Please join us for the Feast of the Assumption, of the Feast of the Annunciation, next Friday, March 25th, 8 a.m. Mass. Wear your favorite color blue to honor the Blessed Mother. Our goal is to make Lent 2022 our best Lent ever. To accomplish this, we need to ask for Jesus' help. So please join me in saying our parish prayer together. Lord Jesus Christ, we ask that you enlighten our minds, inflame our hearts, and make us aware of your great love for us. Increase in us the faith that you are truly here in the Eucharist and in every member of our church. You have defeated death itself and called us to you by our baptism. Thank you for the ways you have blessed our parish community. Help us to communicate to others the joy we have received. We ask this in your holy name. Amen.
And for this Mass, since we are celebrating the RCIA rite, we're going to be doing the Year A readings in your celebremos. So they are going to be on the screen, but they're also going to be in your celebremos book, Year A. Thank you. Thank you.
please stand? Let's sing together. Rain Down, Spirit and Song, number 134.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning,
to prepare ourselves to participate in these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sinfulness in the presence of and all merciful God. I confess Almighty God, have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins. May he bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In silence we pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look on this confession of our lowliness, that we, who are bowed down by our conscience, may always be lifted up by your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Looks so different.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, in their thirst for water, the people grumbled against Moses, saying, "Why did you ever make us leave Egypt? Was it just to have us die here of thirst with our children and our livestock?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? A little more and they will stone me." The Lord answered Moses, "Go over there in front of the people, along with some of the elders of Israel, holding in your hand, as you go, the staff with which you struck the river. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock of Horeb. Strike the rock, and the water will flow from it for the people to drink." This Moses did in the presence of the elders of Israel. The place is called Massah, Meribah, because the Israelites quarreled there and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord in our midst or not?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. brothers and sisters. Since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to his grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of the glory of God. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of land that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. Jesus, tired from his journey, sat down there at the well. It was about noon. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How can you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink?" For Jews use nothing in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God, and who was saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you do not even have a bucket, and the cistern is deep. Where then can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this cistern and drank from it himself with his children and his flocks?" Jesus answered and said to her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water I shall give will never thirst. The water I shall give will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I may not be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go call your husband and come back." The woman answered and said to him, "I do not have a husband." Jesus answered her, "You are right in saying, 'I do not have a husband,' for you have five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you people say the place to worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what you do not understand. We worship what we understand because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is here now when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to him, I know that the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us everything. Jesus said to her, I am he, the one speaking with you. At that moment, his disciples returned and were amazed that he was talking with a woman. But still no one said, what are you looking for? Or why are you talking with her? The woman left her water jar and went into the town and said to the people, come see a man who told me everything I have done. Could he possibly be the Christ? They went out of the town and came to him. Meanwhile, the disciples urged him, Rabbi, eat. But he said to them, I have food to eat of which you do not know. So the disciples said to one another, could someone have brought him something to eat? Jesus said to them, my food is to do the will of the one who sent me and to finish his work. Do you not say, in 4 months the harvest will be here? I tell you, look up and see the fields ripe for the harvest. The reaper is already receiving payment and gathering crops for eternal life, so that the sower and reaper can rejoice together. For here the saying is verified, that one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the work, and you are sharing the fruits of their work. Many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in him because of the word of the woman who testified, he told me everything I have done. When the Samaritans came to him, they invited him to stay with them. He stayed there 2 days. Many more began to believe in him because of his word, and they said to the woman, we no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
This morning we welcome our men and women and children who have chosen to be in conversation with our catechetical staff, faith formation staff, over the last several months as they discern their desire to be a unique part of the Catholic faith and the sacramental life of the Church. The conversation taking place today between our Blessed Lord and the woman of Samaria is no different than the conversations that have taken place between Deacon Mike, Judy Pavelic, Yolanda, our respective faith formation staffs over the last several months. Inviting these men and women and children to explore the depths of their curiosity, to explore the depths of their respective calls as they continue to discern entry into the Catholic Church. We have a record in today's Gospel, maybe of some of the conversation that took place between our Blessed Lord and the woman of Samaria, and the conversation between our Blessed Lord and his disciples. Even the disciples, no different than the woman of Samaria, have many, many questions, even doubts, to try and comprehend what our Blessed Lord is saying to them and doing for them. So today we continue in the tradition of this beautiful Gospel as we journey into the Holy Triduum and Easter Sunday. In the first reading of today's Mass, Moses once again is having a very difficult time with the people of Israel. These people have been displaced, dispossessed. They have become refugees. The political bureaucracy of that time is willing and determined to exterminate them, no different than what is happening in our time in Ukraine. The people of Ukraine have been dispossessed, displaced, have become refugees. The political establishment, through despotic and tyrannical and autocratic regimes, are only too willing to exterminate them. And yet, in the designs and providence of God, Moses has been singled out to lead his people through perilous times. We pray and hope in our time that God may continue to single out leaders with the mind and heart of Moses to lead the people of Ukraine in these perilous times. This continues to be our prayer during each and every celebration of the Eucharist. This is a time to thank your sponsors, to thank your families, to thank your parents, to thank your spouses, to thank your loved ones for walking with you over these past several months, to wake you up, to get you here, to converse with you, to be present for you over all these months. You could not have done this without them, and we thank them most profusely. I see fathers and mothers dropping off their kids, spouses walking with their spouse, partners supporting their partners. This is your time also to be like the woman of Samaria, to be like the disciples who partake in your conversations, who partake in your catechetical studies, who partake in simple question and answer. This is how the faith is transmitted. And God willing, you too will become leaders, not just for your families, but become leaders in your parish and parishes in the years that lie ahead. We always need more leaders, especially in catechesis and in evangelization, to continue to dialogue and share in the beauties and glories of our faith. So please continue on this path, even after the Easter Vigil is over. Engage in new conversations with family members and friends, with neighbors, with employees, with employers. Pay attention to your surroundings, especially your spiritual surroundings, and engage them without shame or fear. No different than our Blessed Lord and the woman of Samaria. No shame, no fear, just bold, honest to God, dialogue, debate, and conversation. This is why and what these catechetical programs provide. And I have no doubt many, many graces will emerge from these conversations, not just over the past several months, but now, and God willing, into the future. Today we welcome the Knights of Columbus, men who love their parish, men who love their community, men who love their faith, men who love their church, men who follow in the footsteps of Blessed Father Michael McGivern, always willing and able to volunteer their time and their talent in service to our church and many worthy organizations and causes throughout this city, throughout the Archdiocese and beyond. I thank our present leadership under the leadership of Ricardo Garcia. This is a time to thank all his predecessors who have served our parish so diligently for many, many, many years. Many are living and many are deceased. We always thank them. It is a nice tradition for the Knights of Columbus to recognize each and every year one night of the year. We were blessed to have many religious priests and deacons serve the Knights of Columbus over many, many years. The present chaplain for the Knights of Columbus here at St. Joseph is Monsignor Peter Flood. And I thank Monsignor Flood, who loves the Knights so much, who loves meetings. But this year, we are recognizing posthumously a knight who passed away suddenly And unexpectedly, before Christmas of 2021, Deacon Freddy Morales, the Knights of Columbus have chosen to recognize Deacon Freddy Morales posthumously for his many, many hours of dedication, not just to the Knights of Columbus, not just to the ordained ministry, but his many, many years of hidden service, always willing to get his hands dirty in service of our parish. His most recent contribution being the Garden of Gethsemane. On behalf of Janie Morales and his family, we thank him for his many clandestine and hidden hours in service to his parish and his community. Not many people are willing to get their hands dirty. They like the publicity. They like to be seen and heard. But rarely do they like to partake in hands-on work behind the scenes. So without further ado, I ask Tom Rosal, Janie Morales, to come forward to receive the Knight of the Year in memory of Deacon Freddy Morales. The elect, please come forward to the front of the altar and face me. Susan Cabrera, Andrew Hernandez, Ryan Horton, Zoe James, Christopher Kendig, Leland Kendig, Mark Kendig, Ramsey Olivares, Brooklyn Winger, and their sponsors. Elect, bow your heads, kneel down and pray. Let us pray for these men and women and children, called forth by the Holy Spirit and chosen by the Church. May this period of purification and enlightenment prepare them for the Paschal Feast, where they find Jesus in his sacraments.
Lord, deliver the elect from fear of the unknown. Save them from the fear of rejection. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Rescue them from lives of anxiety. Grant them tranquility and peace. We pray. In need, we pray to the Lord. recognize your unconditional love and to seek always your forgiveness. We pray. Faithful, reform their lives according to the gospel. May they walk always in your light. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Deliver us from the pride that isolates us from community.
Inspire us to lead lives of service to our neighbors. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, fill us with your living water. Satisfy our thirst for true happiness. We pray.
God of all power, like the woman at the well, these men and women and children thirst for living water. You sent Jesus to be our Savior. May these men, women, and children turn to Jesus as they hear his word. May they acknowledge the sins and weaknesses that weighs us down. Protect them and us from vain self-reliance. Defend them and us from the power of Satan. Free them and us from the spirit of self-deception. Grant that we attain purity of heart and advance on the way of salvation. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, you are the living water for whom all thirst. You are the master whom they seek. In your presence, they open their hearts to you in faith. They confess their faults and lay bare their hidden wounds. In your love, free them and us from all infirmities. Heal our sickness. Quench our thirst, give us peace. Drive out that spirit of evil which you conquered by your rising from the dead. In the power of the Holy Spirit, show your elect the way of salvation. May they come to worship the Father in truth and come finally to the eternal kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Deacon Mike will present a presentation of creed. Study with care the words of our faith by which you will be justified. The words are few, but the mysteries they contain are great. Receive these words with a sincere heart and be faithful to these words. As you take your seats, elect sponsors, be assured of our support and prayers. We look forward one day when you share fully in the Eucharist with us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congregation, we stand and profess our faith in God. I believe.
Yeah. glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism.
With gratitude, we place our prayer into God's presence.
For our Holy Mother Church, that in this time of crisis, may she speak words of truth and justice, act with compassion, and be a sign of Christ's love for all those who are suffering. We pray to the Lord. For all those caught up in violence and war, especially remembering the people of Ukraine, that in this time of fear and conflict, that they may know God's presence and peace. We pray to the Lord. For our St. Joseph Parish and our local community, that in this time of Lent, we may reach out in solidarity to our brothers and sisters in need. We pray to the Lord. For us to hear those cries of God's people who are being oppressed, to save the poor, the vulnerable, the born and unborn, we pray to the Lord. For the sick and their caregivers, that the Lord may keep all under the shelter of his care. And for the dead, may we rejoice as they are embraced by our Lord and Savior in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
In silence, place your own prayer before God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
placing all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, in the presence of Mary, Our Lady of Sorrows, through her Son Jesus. Hail Mary.
At this time, our children are invited to bring their contributions and put them in the basket in front of the altar. Our song for preparation of the gifts is There Is a Longing, Spirit and Song, number 208.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we, who beseech pardon for our own sins, may take care to forgive our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through bodily fasting, you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, bestow virtue and its rewards through Christ our Lord. With all the angels and saints, we praise you as we acclaim. To you, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you first for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. With Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, our Bishop, and all those holding to the truths, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faiths. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer this for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, Joseph, her spouse, your apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John, Paul, Cosmas, Damian, Patrick, Bridget, and all your saints. We ask through their merits and prayers, in all things we are defended by your protecting help. Lord, we pray, accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace. Command, we are delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, approve this offering in every respect. Make this offering spiritual and acceptable, so this may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, once more giving thanks, said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kind countenance, to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, We ask you, Almighty God, command these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty. So all of us who through this participation at this altar receive the holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. To us, your servants, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Grant some share and fellowship with your apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, you fill them with life, you bless them, you bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Our communion song is "Fill My Cup." Fill my cup, Lord.
And then
change our hearts. Breaking Bread, number 648.
Into my heart, O merciful Jesus, I place myself into your presence with all the love of my soul. I pray and beseech thee to fill my heart with living faith,
firm hope, burning charity, holy trust, eternal life, true repentance of my sins, and a firm purpose of amendment. I ponder within myself
Oh, Let us pray.
As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden while still on earth, we ask you, O Lord, what is being brought about in us in mystery may come one day to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your lives. Thanks
be to God.
As we're sent forth, let's sing Holy Patron, Thee Saluting, Breaking Bread number 124.